Welcome back to whatever this series of videos is called. Table Talk. I don't know what it's called. We're just doing this. We're going to have fun. Today, we're going to look at underwater scenarios. We're going to look at underwater combat, underwater stories, underwater levels, all kinds of stuff. Okay, so let's just jump in to Reddit. How would you make a whole campaign underwater? You wouldn't, right? I want to do a Captain Planet adventure. The sea is in trouble, and there's some kind of economic impetus above ground that is hurting the below the ocean stuff. We got to defend the coral reef. We are going to fight off like fantasy oilers. I don't know. I'm thinking about the Great Barrier Reef here. What are the playable races that are underwater? Let's find out. Let's look that up. This is going to be rad. Okay, so here's who we can have. We can have the Grung, who are frog people. We can have this thing, because look at him. Of course he can. I don't want to judge, but here we are judging. We can have a Warforged. They don't need air, food, or water, do they? They're a robot. A turtle? Triton? A triton feels kind of trite. It's a little bit on the nose with this kind of. Lizard folk, I would allow. I'd say, yes, you can have a lizard folk that can breathe. And some of these water elemental people would be appropriate. We've got a pretty cool party there. No humans, no like, you know, specifically very humanoid people either. I like that a lot. Okay, so we are doing an environmental thing. So we'll start the campaign by saying, you are all here to defend the environment. It is under threat by this very specific kind of movement, right? What are other people saying in the thread? Let's check the thread again. A very short campaign. Spoiler, they all drown in the tavern. Hey, we're not doing that. Only amphibious races. We're already past the races. Let's see. Everyone seems to be kind of grappling with the problem of, oh, how are we going to get the characters underwater? Look, you make a campaign for the characters, or you make characters for the campaign. And in this situation, we're saying to the players, we are playing an underwater campaign. Please make an appropriate character. We are going to be dealing with an environmental issue. Please make an appropriate character. And then, oh, we're going to do all this like direct action stuff. We can be out there, you know, disrupting that. We can be Peter. We can be Greenpeace. We can be on a Greenpeace boat. Oh, yeah, this is rad. Okay, the answer is yes. I'm sorry. I thought the answer was going to be no, but it's a yes. All right, let's talk about more underwater stuff, because yes to that. Underwater water breathing conundrum. I bet it's going to have an easy answer. This is a very important rules clarification that I need. If you filled a pool with potion of underwater breathing, is it possible to drown in the pool? Oh, yeah, that's pretty weird. You know, the way I deal with potions is because players always want to do this crap stuff. They want to be like, okay, I've got a potion of healing. I just want to take a sip of it to get one hit point. Can I just have a sip to get one hit point? And I have to be really ham-fisted with my ruling and say, no, there's a magical enchantment on the potion so that it only activates if you drink the whole thing. Oh man, if I was being very rules lawyer Perkins, which sometimes I have to do, I might even say no. You can drown in that underwater breathing pool. What are people saying? Probably yes and no. Those are the default answers. This is bad content. I gotta leave. Let's find something about battle maps or dungeons or combat. Would Sacred Flame work underwater? Yes, because Sacred Flame is not a fire spell. It has flame in the name, but that's probably just for legal distinctions, for legal branding reasons. It's actually radiant light, and light goes through water. Maybe it would refract a bit. Maybe it would split into a beautiful little prismatic radiant flame. That would be quite fun. But yes, it will work. Underwater combat in general has a bunch of little rules that people forget. There are some specific weapons that are good underwater. And when I say good, it means you don't have to roll disadvantage when you use them. You can use your crossbow underwater. It's one of the few ranged weapons. You can use, oh, what else can you use? Like a trident you can use underwater. I think some, like maybe like a rapier and maybe, oh, I can't remember exactly. I can't remember. Somebody tell me. But also, who cares about the rules? You can do what you want. This is a good one. This person's saying, it's magic. It works. Of course it does. And that's because people often try and logic their ways out of the fun magical stuff in D&D. I remember once seeing a dungeon master say, this creature is, the only thing that can hurt it is magic damage, right? And so we have a magical flaming sword. So we hit them with the sword and he goes, yeah, that's doing fire damage. It's like, no, it's a magic sword. Yeah, it's like, yeah, but it's not fire, so it's doing fire damage. It's like, but it is a magical sword. It's not just like a sword that we negligently let catch on fire. It's a magical flaming sword. But because it's playing logic to magic. Don't do that. No logic. Magic only, please. Ideas for an underwater temple? Let's do that. Underwater temple. I'm writing a temple dungeon that takes place underwater. I have ideas for the boss, the story, the objectives, etc. But I'm in need of smaller puzzle rooms. Does anybody have any ideas? It's set fully underwater, no air whatsoever. This person is clearly thinking of, what's that game? Ocarina of Time. That water dungeon. Oof, woof. Everybody always talks about how hard the water dungeon was, but I don't actually remember how hard it was. I played it when I was a kid, but frankly, I would have put up with anything for video games back then. I think a lot of video games mistreated me and kind of wasted my time. So, what would you do? Underwater temple. I remember in Ocarina of Time, they had those boots so that you would have to walk, right? Let's look them up. Where are they? The iron boots. You know, you got these boots and they let you walk on the bottom of the water, and you needed to get these in order to progress in the game. That was kind of fun. Now that I'm thinking about it, that's really dangerous. Like, you shouldn't do that. If you have boots that are so heavy that they're dragging you to the bottom, how effective are you going to be at actually walking? Like, I reckon you'd do your knees. Hover boots. Oh, these let you walk on water and these lets you walk underwater. Yeah. You know what I want to do? I want to do the opposite. I want boots that when I'm underwater, if you flip me upside down, oh, I'm flipping you off. If you flip me upside, sorry. Like, you imagine your feet are facing towards the sky and you're walking along the surface of the water, like on the opposite end. Isn't that kind of fun? And like the only way that your friend can cross, it's like a puzzle. And the only way that your friend can cross is by stepping where you step. And you have to both kind of like step across like that in order to cross this puzzle. That's one of the puzzles that I would include. Man, if you talk for long enough, you just find your way to an answer. This is beautiful. Let's see what people are suggesting. Underwater temple filled with puzzles and traps is ideal for a Naga. Yeah, who's going to be in the underwater temple? Now, a Naga is like a snake. Yep, that's a snake. That's a snake. Wow. Okay, a Naga. I kind of like the idea of a giant snake, like an eel. Like, if I just type in monster eel. Oh! Oh, man. Ugh. Let's do one more question. I can't think about underwater sea creatures anymore. But art. I made some terrain for an underwater encounter. Let's take a look. I like art. That's fun. It's got like the seabed floor and then the seaweed coming up. Dude, if you want to do an underwater campaign and you want to do underwater encounters, do you know where you head? You go to the pet store. Let's look up fish tank stuff. I reckon you could use fish tank supplies just for regular terrain. This is perfect. The coolest thing you could do is actually, how much does paint like being put into water? I think you could actually put the player's miniatures in the fish tank, fill it with water, weight them with some kind of washer or coin, let them put them down to the bottom, and actually have the battle map be in there. Don't put any fish in there, though, because it would be quite disturbing and distressful for them to have hands come in and move the dragon every now and then. Thanks for hanging out for another chill video where I just go through some Reddit stuff. This was underwater themes in general. If there's anything I've said today that you would like to see a full video on, just let me know. Maybe I'll make an actual high effort video content about something that I've said here. If you're interested, I don't know. What should I talk about next?